Hi everyone, this is Kelly from Truth and Story, and I thought today we would just talk a little bit on our Junermon path. We would talk a little bit about the happy cards for in the Lenormand deck. And so I have picked a few cards here. I should have picked some more, but you know, I just did what I could here. I don't really need this up here, put that over there. So the cards that I'm talking about are the Clover card, the Bouquet card, and the Sun card. So today is day two of Junermon. So the cards that I picked from, the way that I'm doing Junermon, is I'm picking from, you know, finding the card and then seeing what the message on either side of that was, which today was for Clover, which I already did and posted on Instagram and such. But, it, you know, I've been thinking a lot about these three cards, both in when I'm giving readings, I've been chewing these over, as well as obviously in working up, in the process of working on my guidebook, I thought a lot about these cards because they're, all three of them have to do with happiness. But there's a little, there's differences in how that energy, this is what it's boiled down to for me personally. Again, whatever I'm talking about, unless I'm saying, you know, this is the way it is because XYZ says it so, and, you know, whatever, if, unless that occasion, everything that I'm saying is comes from my own personal experience with working with the cards or whatever it is that we're talking about, which in this case is Lenormand. And so in my experience, traditionally you'll see a Clover as being sort of little luck and happiness, and Bouquet sort of being big luck and big happiness, or bigger luck and bigger happiness. And then Sun card is just like shining down on everything, and it kind of raises everything up, but it's that big, you know, that's the big daddy of happiness cards. So it seemed almost to be by measure, you know, from smallest to largest influence. But I come to find, especially with these two, this is that. The Sun card is, for me, very similar to the Sun card in tarot, in that there is great, great happiness, but it's a happiness that kind of lights up from within. You know, it is that idea of growth, which I think about with the Sun card in tarot, just that terms of the reason why you're feeling that happiness in the Sun card is because you've grown through the rest of the major arcana up to that point. So I just feel like if the sun is shining down, it's causing things to grow, right? This is about happiness and successful growth, successful happiness that comes out of success and successful growth. So there is both an external in that it lifts everything up, but there is also that sense of growth and confidence from within as well that you get with the Sun card. Here's the Sun card from the Claire de Lune. Here's the Sun card from the Bluebird Lenormand. And here's the adorable Sun card with, I don't generally like faces in Sun cards, but I like that one with the kind of 60s glasses from the Maybe Lenormand. And then this is the Sun card from the Story in Color Lenormand, my deck. So there's just that sense of brightness that just lifts everything up and causes everything to grow. So that's the big one, right? So that makes sense. So, okay, we got that one. That makes sense. But then you start to look at these two and you think, okay, so now we've got the Clover, you know, over here on this side, we've got the Clover, and over here on this side, we've got the flowers or the bouquet cards, again, from Claire de Lune, Bluebird, and Maybe Lenormand. I love that bouquet as well. For me, these two cards have really gone the way or come about to mean a little bit more how they come to you. So if you think about the bouquet, okay, this is a little bit easier to make sense of, right? Okay, bam, somebody sends you a bouquet. You're sitting in your office and somebody sends you a bouquet of flowers, and there's that feeling of happiness, that feeling of joy that somebody has sent to you. So that energy of happiness is joy, and joy joy is coming to you because of the action of somebody else. So that, you know, you can really start to see, okay, well, I'm really happy, but in some way that is caused by something that is coming to you. Versus the clover, which to me doesn't necessarily mean less happiness or less luck, but it is a little bit more, we've just kind of stumbled on it. It wasn't something that we were expecting, because if you're looking for a four-leaf clover, I mean, sometimes you're mindfully hunting for a four-leaf clover, but most of the time, you know, if you're walking along and you're looking down and you're looking at things, you might all of a sudden see that four-leaf clover. And it's that idea that because I was walking mindfully and pay attention to where my foot was stepping, I saw this, I stumbled on this piece of happiness and luck. It's something that I came on accidentally, but out of mindfulness. Because if I wasn't paying attention, I would never have seen it. Does that make sense? That's kind of how I, inexperientially. So, you know, there's a lot, we talked about the last video, I talked a lot about intuition and sort of building on those layers. So you have traditional understandings of cards, whatever, whether it's tarot, Lenormand, whatever it might be. We have those layers of, where, okay, we've got the foundational, we get our foundation, we figure out what our keywords are, we get a base understanding of the cards, right? Then we have our intuition that comes in that says, okay, what does the clover mean to me? Based on all of the things that clover says, four-leaf clover, good luck, in regular culture, based on what it means in the Lenormand deck, based on what it means to me in this moment with this particular question and this particular person. So we've tapped into those different layers, right? Whenever we're reading cards, it's never just coming from one place. It's coming from a multitude of things. The other layer that we add into this is simply through experience. So that the more that we work with tarot, or the more that we work with Lenormand, or the more that we work with a specific oracle system, and even more so perhaps the more that we work with a specific deck, although that's not so much true in Lenormand, but in other cases that can be the case, especially if you're really looking to the images, depending on your reading style. But the more that we work with a system, the more that we gain experiential knowledge. So we see the way that it comes up over and over again, and the way that it ends up meaning, and the way that it ends up, and we gain that experiential knowledge. That is a whole nother layer, right? That really starts to take something that's kind of, okay, this is the clover, and these are the keywords, and this is what it means, and if it's in love, it means this, if it's career, it means this, if it's this, it means that. You know, so we have all that kind of rigid, right? So then we let our intuition play around in there. And then the more the readings that we do, the more readings that we do, we start to see, how does it actually show up? What is it actually saying around love? What is it actually saying when somebody's feeling stuck? What is it actually saying when somebody is, you know, looking to get another job? What is it saying, right? That experiential knowledge. And for me, experientially, this card has definitely taken on that connotation of pay attention, because you might miss it, right? So it's that idea of, this is happiness that is going to come. This is that bit of luck that's coming your way. But if you're not careful, you're going to miss it. You need to be being mindful. It's something that you can't make happen. It's going to happen on its own. It's a natural causation. I'm walking along and I see a four-leaf clover. So you can't necessarily force it to happen, but you've got to be aware. You've got to be walking through life with your eyes open so that you don't miss those moments of real luck and happiness. It can also be, if somebody is like really feeling down and feeling stuck, it can be those kind of ideas of okay, well, right now things aren't going really good, but if you're being mindful and if you're really looking, if you're looking to not miss out, where are those areas in which there is luck and happiness in your life, but you may not be paying attention to it, you may not be seeing it? Apologize, Isabella's. It's a beautiful, beautiful day, and so Isabella's all sassy on the porch. So So that's kind of the difference for me. So yes, traditionally you can use this as a little bit of luck and happiness, and the bouquet is a big luck and happiness. Traditionally, this is something that is coming to you, something that somebody gives to you, right? It's like a gift. It's something that's given. You get surprised by this bouquet of flowers. What a wonderful feeling that is. And this is one of those lucky happenstances. Do we not love the word happenstance? I love the word happenstance. You know, a long time ago, I remember getting a box of, you know, our library used to have, I think it was at a library. No, I think it was an estate sale. Anyways, I bought a box of books. I think it was at like a garage, it was bigger than a garage, so it was like a estate sale, and there was a box of books, used books, and, you know, for pennies or whatever. And so I picked up this box of books and took it home, and in this box of books was a really old Bible, and I have it somewhere. It's probably in my storage locker in the basement, but I do have this somewhere. I tried to hold on to it throughout moves, but it was a really old Bible, and inside of this Bible were all of these pressed four-leaf clovers. A bunch of them, just paid, you know, between all of the pages. And what an amazing, that was one of these clover moments, with literally with clovers, right, where you just stumble on this, somebody for a lifetime, right, collected four-leaf clovers and kept them in this Bible. And then that very act of just opening this up and finding, it was such a neat experience to have that snapshot kind of kick into somebody else's life where they had collected these beautiful moments of four-leaf clovers throughout their lifetime. And there I was holding that in my hand. That's a four-leaf clover moment, right? That's a Lenormand clover moment where you just didn't unexpectedly, but because you're paying attention and choose to open the book and look. If I just set the old Bible aside, I never would have seen it, right? So it's like that mindfulness or that presence, being present, allows you to stumble on those moments. So it's kind of that interesting juxtaposition between mindfulness and being awake and deliberate, as well as that the random happenstance. And because the way those two synchronicity works together, you have this moment. And so that's kind of how I see the clover card and the bouquet card, and then the all-inspiring, wonderful sun card at the top. So I just thought for today's little video that we would take a little look at the three kind of happy, not that there aren't any other happy cards in Lenormand, but these are kind of the three happiness cards and how we might see those. I'd love to see how you see these three cards, because you may see them completely different, and we can always learn from each other. But I'm excited to hear how the rest of you might approach these three cards in a reading. And thank you so much for watching, and I hope that you are having a wonderful beginning of June.